There is no doubt that the value proposition of advisor needs to change and needs to evolve. If you go back 10 years ago, 10 years ago, the value proposition fit in a really nice little box. You know, there was beta, that was access to the markets, and that's now being repriced to virtually free. Access to markets is not really a value proposition. You have alpha, which is excess return, and that's been negative for a while, and at best, it's probably not that much, right? So what's in the box is alpha and beta, and those two things are free and not so much, right? And so the reality is, as I think about, and I talk to advisors about value proposition, it's what things are not in that box, because that's really the value proposition that clients want and need. And really, it's them. It's what they bring to the table, and it's their connection. And I think the biggest part of that is planning. I think advisors that are beginning to take a broader and more wide-based planning perspective and a part of their business are going to end up with the value proposition that is most valued by customers going forward. And it's not just any part of the value chain. And as it relates to when you think about this element of financial planning's got a spectrum. And so you can either be simple financial planning, think of that as goals-based, or the most complex plans and everywhere in between. It doesn't matter where you live with financial planning. It just matters that financial planning is going to end up being the value proposition that really sets advisors apart going forward. You know, when robo-advice first came out, you thought it was a way to disintermediate the advisor. The reality is that's not the case. The reality is that what it brought was innovation and thinking and a new way to intersect with a new population, not only a demographic, but a geographic of clients. And those two things were brought in now and are being orchestrated into the overall value chain. So what robo-advice is doing two things. Number one is it's bringing financial literacy to more people. And we need that. You know, here in America, our financial literacy is not where it needs to be. And it's helping with that. And that's good for everybody. The second thing that it's doing is it's bringing innovation and new thought leadership to an industry that hasn't always innovated. And that innovation is helping in a very interesting spot. It's that spot that is right where the customer is. It's that intersection between the advisor and the customer. And that innovation is extraordinary and extraordinarily important.